the Lord, and thank you for joining another broadcast of Kingdom Life here at All Saints Kingdom Church in Montgomery, Alabama. We thank you for joining us on today, and we pray that God will bless you and that he will feed you, and that you will find this word that we're going to share with you today, one that will be uplifting and encouraging. We ask you to focus your ears on hearing what the Lord is saying, and also open your eyes so that you can see what he is doing as he moves in the earth on today. I ask you to get your Bible, whichever device you're going to use, whether it's a printed Bible or your phone or your laptop or your iPad, whatever it is so important that we spend time in the Word of God. It is also important that when you're listening to others share the Word, that when you can, you read right along with them. And so go and get your Bible. We're going to be finishing up our series today on Sharpen Your Ax. Sharpen Your Ax. And today we're going to be looking at the last part of it, which is check your attitude. Check your attitude. We've looked at several messages dealing with sharpening your axe. We first looked at spending time with God. We looked at being obedient to God. We looked at walking in faith and being faithful to God. We looked at walking in love and loving God and his people. Then last time we looked at getting rid of stinking thinking, and we are going to conclude today with checking your attitude, because the key thing is this: anything that we do, if our attitude is not right, whether it's concerning God or it is concerning other people, then we're going to have difficulty in life. And so we thank you for being with us. Let us just go to the throne of grace for just a moment as we before we go into the word. Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, we thank you for another day. We thank you for your blessings upon us. We thank you that we have ears to hear and eyes to see. We thank you, Lord, that it is your desire that we be aware of what you're doing in the earth. And so, Father, as you help us to grow in you, as you help us to sharpen our axe so that we will be able to defeat the devil in every area of our lives, we thank you for your help on today. And we ask you to have your way in our lives and do with us what you want to do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's go on and get into the word today as we look at a new checking our attitude. In 1995, Patti LaBelle released a hit record called New Attitude. And the lyrics of these songs, if you would go back and look at that, she talks about how that things were going all wrong in her life, but because of a new attitude, because things were had changed in her mind and in her heart and in her life, she began to say, you know, now she had a new point of view. Now she had a new attitude and she was in control, and now her worries were few. Why all of that happened is because she had a new attitude. She went on to say, I'm wearing a new dress and a new hat, and she got new ideas, and as a matter of fact, she was changed for good. I believe, and I know some of you are saying, what pastor's talking about Patti LaBelle and a song that a secular song? But many times, if you pay attention to it, even the secular songs can give us something that will be a blessing to us. And I would think that even though we may not sing this song, we as born-again, fire baptized believers should be saying or singing like Patti LaBelle did, I have have a new attitude. Something, when we come to the Lord, it ought to change. And as we grow in God, something ought to change. The way we look at things, the way we think about things, the way we view things, it ought to change. Where that we can say, I don't think the way I used to think. I don't look at things the way I used to. In fact, my whole attitude is different. According to the Merriam-Webster dictionary, the word attitude means an internal position or feeling with regard to something. In other words, it is often used synonyms are disposition, feeling, mood, opinion, sentiment, temper, or tone. Our perspective, our frame of mind, our outlook, our view, or our morale. All of those are part of what we think about or what we would use when we are talking about an attitude. An attitude is a settled way of thinking or feeling about someone or something. Typically one that is reflected in our behavior. How we feel, how we think about things will cause us to react a certain way. If we have an attitude toward a person, then a negative attitude, because our attitudes can be positive. But if we have a negative attitude toward a person, then how we respond to that person often will be negative. And so we want to have the right kind of attitude. As born-again believers, we don't just want to say that we want a positive attitude, but we want a God-given attitude, a God where we see him in the right way, and a God where an attitude where we see each other in the right way. In other attitudes form the soil and the root out of which actions grow. Attitudes can be like cobwebs, which clutter up our mind and causes us to fail in the purposes of God. Or they can be like an interstate highway to an automobile, something the way to our destination. And so if we want God to bless us and we want to feel good about our walk with God, we must have the right attitude. So I encourage you today, check your attitude. Make sure that the way you feel about people and things, make sure that it is right. Make sure that it is based upon the Word of God. Check your attitude. Because attitudes are so important, Scripture has a great deal to say about our thinking processes, which produces our attitudes and which in turn produce our actions. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Christ died so that we would not have to stay with that same stinking thinking and with that same bad attitude that we have. He wants us to be made new. And he declares that everything becomes new. He made us new. Now it's up to us to be able to walk in that newness. And that, like most things, when it comes to salvation and it comes to holiness and it comes to sanctification, it comes to being whole, we understand that it is a process. We've got to recognize, you know, my thinking is off. My attitude about stuff is not right. And so, Father, I need you to help me change my attitude. Philippians 2:1-8 says, if there be therefore any consolation in Christ, if any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any bowels of the mercies, fulfill ye my joy, that ye be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord, of one mind. Let nothing be done through strife or vainglory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem other better than themselves. Have the right attitude about each other. I want to stop a minute there and just say, that attitude should be based on the fact that we know that all of us were created in the image of God. And therefore, we should look at others, we should treat others based on the fact that they are represent God in the earth, even if they're not living right, if they're not doing right, if they're not talking right, whatever it is, they are still image bearers. They still represent Christ in the earth. And so we need to have the right attitude. We can't look at people as some being low and some being high and some being one thing or some being another. We can't have a superior attitude toward people, because we need to have the right attitude. And that attitude is, God created them the same way he created me. And so they are due respect and honor. They are due love and kindness and gentleness and mercy. So we want to keep that in mind. Verse 4 goes on to say, look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. Our attitude should be, I'm just as concerned about you as I am about me. And that may not always be an easy thing, because most of us, if we will admit it, we are more concerned about ourselves than we are about other people. We are more concerned about our own issues and our own family and our own job and whatever it is that relate to us. But the Bible clearly tells us to look not on our own things, but every man also on the things of others. And then in verse 5 it says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. That's what we need to have. If we want to have a right attitude, if we want to walk according to the word of God, if we want to walk in a way that pleases God, then we are going to have the mind of Christ. And he's willing to give it to us. He wants us to have it. The only thing is, we got to want to exchange ours for him. We got to give up our way. We got to give up our will. We got to give up our thoughts. We got to give up our attitude. Many times, and I've said it, and many of you probably have said it, this is just the way I am. Aren't you glad today, though, that God died, Jesus died, so that we would not have to stay? Oh my goodness, think about how messed up we were. Think about, some of you can think about how messed up you still are. Aren't you glad today that Jesus shed his precious blood on the cross, so that you don't have to go through life messed up? You don't have to go through life with stinking thinking. You don't have to go through life with a bad attitude, always with something wrong, always feeling bad and negative about things. But you can go through life with the mind of Christ, looking at things in a positive way, looking at things in a way that encourages yourself even as you encourage others. So we thank God for the mind of Christ. He said, let this mind, which means that it's there, it's available, but we have to want it to be a part of us. We have to let him come in, and we have to allow him to do in us what he wants to do, so that he can change the way we think. He can change the way we talk. He can change the way we act. And he can change the way we feel about things. I was reading on something, and it was talking about how airplane pilots often use attitude to describe their horizontal relationship with the runway when they land. If their attitude, not altitude, but if their attitude isn't aligned properly, the plane will make contact with the ground at the wrong angle, and it will cause them to crash. I believe that this is true with us. If our attitude is not right, we're going to clash with our family. We're going to clash with our friends. We're going to clash with our employers. We're going to clash with other people in the church. We're going to clash with our neighbors, because our attitude is not right. It's got to be right so that we can line up. We can be in agreement. We can be in a positive relationship with others. In essence, our attitude is our inward disposition toward other things, such as people or circumstances, As with the airplane, attitude is applied whenever you must deal with something or someone else. And it's got to be right in order for that dealing, for that interaction to be right. I don't know about you. I don't want to crash. I don't want to crash in my relationship with God. I don't want to crash in my relationship with my family or with my friends or any of the people that I'm involved with. But I want it to be right. And in order for it to be right, my attitude must be right. In order for your relationships to be right, your attitude must be right. You must think about these things in the right way. You must be willing to understand them, to be patient with them, and even to forgive them when necessary. According to God's word, when we become a Christian, a part of our new creation is the development of new attitudes. Your attitude should become like Jesus. Jesus had a mind of obedience. We see that he had a mind of empathy and sympathy. He had a mind of concern, of caring. He was just concerned about people all around him. The Bible says that our attitude should be the same as that as Jesus Christ, coming from Philippians 2 and 5. We are taught with regard to our former ways to put off the old self, which is being corrupted by its deceitful desires, to be made new in the attitudes of your mind. Ephesians 4 and 22. We must have the right attitude. Now let's talk a minute about bad attitudes. Most of us can easily identify bad attitudes when they are displayed. We look at the words or the actions such as negativeness, criticalness, rebellion, defiance, impatience, uncooperativeness, apathy, discouragement, independence, presumption, all of those things are rudeness. All of those things have to do with our attitude. We think we are better than. One of the prevailing attitudes that I see in the earth today is one of entitledness. That's an attitude where that people think they are entitled. Oftentimes I hear people my age talking about how younger people feel like they are entitled. They are entitled to things that they think they want. They are entitled to more than what they have. They're entitled to whatever it is that they want. They feel like they're entitled. We even see commercials on TV where they're talking about get what you are entitled to. Because, you know, that's just the attitude, the prevailing attitude of people in the earth today. We are entitled. But I don't know about you, but let me share with you today. We don't want what we are entitled to. We don't want what really should be coming to us, but we want what God, through his grace and mercy, has prepared for us, which is eternal life. Because the Bible clearly says the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. So what I'm entitled to is death, but thanks be unto God, he has allowed us to be able to live a life that will lead to eternal life. So we want to get rid of bad attitudes and put on some good attitudes. According to scripture, our attitude toward life, our circumstances, or toward other people should always be like the Lord's, as it is defined by scripture. Good attitudes are generally demonstrated by being positive, encouraging, loving, humble, teachable, cooperative, considerate, selfless, loyal, and persevering. And so we want to make sure that we have good attitudes and rather than bad attitudes. We got to have the right attitude toward God. We've got to have the right attitude toward our family. We've got to have the right attitude toward authority. We must even have the right attitude toward our hard circumstances. We need to learn to be patient. We need to learn that because of going through, we develop patience, and that in that patience, we possess our soul. So we got to have the right attitude toward difficulties in our lives. We've got to have the right attitude toward our church. We've got to have the right right attitude toward duties, and we got to have the right attitude toward fairness and unfairness. We've got to have the right attitude toward the lost and toward those who are still living in sin, being thankful that we know that if it were not for the grace of God, we would still be living in sin. We would still be on our way to hell. And so we've got to love those who don't know Christ. We've got to love those who are still walking on the path to death and have the right attitude toward them. So how is it that we develop good attitudes? Number one, identify and repent of bad attitudes. Amen. If you don't have the right feeling toward a person or a thing, then you need to identify that and ask God to help you with it. The second one is submit your attitudes to God. Give it to Him. Give it to Him and say, Lord, I don't feel right about this. I don't feel right about this person. Every time I see them, something happens in me and it's not a good thing. Lord, I give that to you. And the third thing is to equip and feed your attitudes. Equip it with the word of God. Feed it with the word of God. Feed it by being around people who are. Have you noticed that we prefer to be around people with good attitudes? Those people who are positive rather than those people with bad attitudes and who are negative. And so we want to make sure that we keep a positive attitude. Right attitude should be reflected by the things that we do. And when we talk about, first of all, you got to have the same mind. You got to stay in the Word of God so that you can feed yourself the good things of God. And that will affect how you think. It will affect how you feel. It will affect how you behave toward others. You can't stay in the Word of God and have a negative attitude toward other people unless you're not listening and unless you're not allowing the Spirit of God to work in you. Because even though we may be doing well, even as we read the Word of God, we know we can't have a legalistic attitude toward other people. We've got to be merciful. We've got to be compassionate. We've got to show grace to other people the same way we want God to show grace to us. So we've got to have the right attitude toward things. If something bad happens to you, don't give up on God. Just say, God, I thank you that you helped me to come through it, or that you're helping me to come through it. That attitude will make a difference. A positive attitude, a right attitude, seeing God in the right way, seeing others in the right way, and feeling toward them the way that you should will make a difference in our lives. It will sharpen our axe, excuse me, because what the devil really wants to do, he wants you to have a negative attitude. He wants you to walk in that. He wants you to stay in that so he can feed your heart and feed your mind with all of these things about what God has not done, what other folk have not done, how bad things are in your life, how everybody else has it so much better than you are. And so he wants to feed that, but don't let him feed that foolishness into you. Look at what God has done. If you woke up this morning, God is good. Hallelujah. And from that, we develop an attitude of thankfulness, an attitude of being grateful, an attitude of appreciation, an attitude of love and kindness. I encourage you today, check your attitude. Check your attitude. As we conclude this series on today, I would ask you this. To adjust your attitude where God is and allow him to show you what need to change. God loves you the way you are, but he did not die so that you would stay that way. He came so that we could be changed. For a believer, for the Christians, we must understand that we're not just talking about walking around with a, oh, I'm so happy and everything is all right. That's not at all what I'm talking about. But it's about the attitude of seeing the people and things through the eyes of God. So as we close today, I just want to pray with you and then invite you to call us if you need to, or if you want to, email us if you want to, because we would love to hear from you. And and we would also love to pray for you. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you today for your loving kindness. We thank you for your goodness and mercy, and we thank you that you will not leave us the way that you found us, but you clean us up and you make us strong. You heal us and you provide for us. You protect us and you change the way we think. As we will surrender and submit to you, God, you will make us what you want us to be. You will make us the way you want us to be. And Father, you will do it in your time. And so we thank you today and we praise you in Jesus' name. Glory to God. I pray that you have been blessed on today. I pray that you will make up your mind to sharpen your axe. Remember, we sharpen our axe by spending time with God. We sharpen our axe by being obedient to God. We sharpen our axe by walking in faith and being faithful to God. We sharpen our axe by walking in love and loving God and his people. We sharpen our axe by getting rid of stinking thinking. And finally, we sharpen our axe by checking and correcting our attitudes. I encourage you to be blessed and to walk in the blessings of the Lord today. Again, if you want to contact us, our number here is 334-649-1040. If you want to email us, you can do so at allsaintskingdomchurch7@gmail.com. We love you and we pray God's blessings upon you. And as I end this broadcast, I ask you to look to Jesus, who is the author and finisher of our faith. And he is the one who has promised us that he will always be with us, even until the end of the world. Be blessed. God love you, and so do we.